interest in man. The study is a part of my PhD thesis and it has been done at Department of Botany, Mohanlal Oswal Institute, Udaipur, in collaboration with Indigenous Drug Research Center, R&D Medical College, Udaipur. Now, the plant, Ibomia digitata, it is a perennial twinner, a member of family Cormoranthaceae, and it is commonly known as Shirvidari or Vidari Kanda, and it is found in tropical parts of India, in Bihar, Bengal, West Bengal, and Deccan, Assam, and West Coast from Konkan to Kerala. And ethnomedicinally, the tuber of this plant has been used in for treatment of gastrointestinal, genitourinary, and respiratory disorder. And it is one of the plants which has been used in drought simulation for treatment of cardiovascular ailments. Now, scientifically, the tuber of Ibomia digitata has been evaluated for its antioxidant, hepatoprotective, oxytocic, and antihypertensive properties in in vitro studies and animal models. However, so far no human study has been still done, so therefore the present study has been undertaken. About material and methods, the plant was collected from the forest of West Midnapur, West Bengal, and it was after identification and authentication cultivated at Udaipur, and the tuber was harvested in the month of December, and it was cut into small pieces, air dried in shade at an ambient temperature and grinded to make a fine homogeneous powder which was filled in the little capsules, and each capsule contained 750 milligrams of the powder, and matched placebo were also prepared by filling the capsules with lactose powder. Now what the subjects? Middle-aged, non-obese, stage 1 hypertensive male individuals were selected for the study, and they were divided into two groups. Group 1, the treated group received 3 gram tuber powder in 2 divided doses for 12 weeks, and group 2, the control group received matched placebo. Now all the blood samples were collected initially and at the end of 4th, 8th and 12th week for estimation of plasma fibrinolytic activity, serum total antioxidant status and various lipid fractions. All the tests were conducted with standard kits or standard biochemical methods. Blood pressure was measured as per the recommendations of JNC-7 by a mercury sphygmomanometer in sitting position with the average of 2 or more minutes with a gap of 5 minutes, and mean blood pressure was also calculated by addition of diastolic blood pressure to 1/3 of pulse pressure. Now about the results. Administration of Shirvidari has progressively reduced the systolic, diastolic and mean blood pressure, and the effect was started at the end of 4th week. The placebo group, however, did not show any significant change in blood pressure. So at the end of 12th week, there was a 39 mm fall in systolic, 19 mm in diastolic and 26 mm fall in mean blood pressure. And this statistically significant fall in systolic, diastolic and mean blood pressure is quite important because randomized control trials have shown that in patients with mild hypertension, a fall of 10 mm in systolic and 5 to 6 mm in diastolic blood pressure reduced the stroke risk by 1/3 and risk of coronary events by 1/6. Now, the plant has also improved significantly and progressively the fibrinolytic activity at all the levels of the study. Fibrinolytic activity is a major means of disposing of the fibrin fiber after its hemostatic function has been fulfilled. However, the placebo group did not show any significant change in the fibrinolytic activity. Interestingly, tuber has also demonstrated a significant rise in serum total antioxidant level at all the levels of the study. And the rise was up to more than 100% at the end of 12 weeks. There was no significant change observed in various lipid fractions at the end of 4th and 8th week. However, at the end of 12th week, there was a significant fall in total cholesterol, LDL cholesterol and atherogenic index, along with a significant rise in HDL-LDL ratio. Both HDL-LDL ratio and atherogenic index, they are important parameters for evaluation of underlying coronary atherosclerosis, and they are good predictor of prognosis. And both these parameters have been favorably modified by Shirvidari. And moreover, the early effect of Shirvidari on total antioxidant status is beneficial in improving and preventing the oxidation of LDL cholesterol, which has decreased at a later stage. So this observation is quite important in terms of prevention of atherosclerosis. Now to summarize, along with the significant reduction in blood pressure, the Shirvidari has significantly increased fibrinolytic activity by 46%, speed of total antioxidant status by 103%, LDL-LDL ratio by 45%, and significant fall of 26% in total cholesterol, 32% in LDL cholesterol, and 25% in atherogenic index has been observed. And this alteration in various risk parameters is quite important, and it can be very well be explained on the basis of its phytochemical constituents such as amylopectin, scopolamine, beta-sitosterol, which are all for their antioxidant and antihypertensive, hypercholesterolemic activities in animal studies. Now to conclude, Eyebovia digitata tuber has proved to be a good antioxidant, effective antihypertensive, useful hypolipidemic and beneficial thrombolytic agent, and thereby improving endothelial function. It is a safe and effective plant-derived therapeutic agent which can be considered in patients with stage 1 hypertension with associated lipid and clotting abnormalities, having an added advantage of its antioxidant potential. And this study has first time validated the ethnomedicinal uses of Eyebovia digitata tuber in cardiovascular diseases. However, long-term double-blinded vascular control studies with large number of patients are also warranted.